In this video, I share ideas about setting expectations, how to get the children to the playground, and then how to get them back into the classroom, as well as some best practices. And stick around to the end where I will share some activities and games that you can do as well. Stay tuned. Okay, so let's talk about setting expectations before. So this is so that you can ensure their safety as well as promoting some positive behavior while they are out there on the playground. So you may want to talk about using the equipment outside or the different structures safety. You want to make sure that you are talking about how to use those things. So basically talking about how to use them appropriately. So in terms of, you know, the climbers are for climbing, and then also for safety. So whether it's, you know, having them not jump off of the climbers, for instance. Another expectation to set is maybe taking turns. Like, what does that look like? And these are things that you talk about or do in your classroom, but you're just taking it outside of the classroom. So you talk about taking turns in the classroom. What does that look like when they are outside on the playground? And then there's also talking about what to do when there's like a disagreement about something. You wanna give them the steps on how to handle that as well. One of them could be like keeping their hands and their feet to themselves, for one. But you also want to make sure that you are talking about those things and discussing those things when you are discussing the expectation. So let's get into how to get there, how to get to the playground. And this may sound like, duh, you just walk them out to the playground. But no, there are other things that are involved that need to be put in place before you even get them to the playground. So one thing you can do is to ensure that transition activity before you even get them out of the classroom. So that transition activity will be something that will leave enough room for them to be able to play and have all their time or most of their time while they are outside. So I discussed transitions activities in a few other videos that I had, and I'll put one of them in the cards so that you can take a look at that as well. So the next thing you want to talk about is, or you want to do, is get them online. So however you do that, that's the next step, part of this before, or how to get there. So I do talk about how to get children to line up in another video, so I will put that one in the cards as well. While they are online, you may want to reiterate some of those things that you've talked about as far as your expectations, but this time maybe you want to include your expectations for them to walk from the classroom to the playground. So giving them those reminders if you've already talked to them about it, or letting them know what is about to take place. And then the other thing, which kind of piggybacks off of getting them online, not only getting them online, but also like the reminder part of what you're doing, is also maybe giving them some type of walking challenge. The challenge is for you to get them to the playground. Now you're actually going to be walking with them to the playground, but how do you want them walking? So it depends on a lot of different factors, but sometimes you may have to walk them in a hallway where there's other classrooms, maybe even the office. So how are you going to get them there in a manner that won't disturb other classes? And then the other thing, now that you have did the challenge, they have gotten to the playground, how are you going to release them? So do you want it to just be have at it, you know, and let them run, you know, off? Or do you want to do it in a more safe kind of way? So maybe, you know, releasing them a few children at a time, or you have some type of other cue to release them, or you've given them some other direction on how they are to move from the line to the playground itself. So figure out what is the procedure from that point on. What are they supposed to do in order to now get to the play area and what they're going to do there? And then they're on the playground. So what happens next? So let's talk about some best practices. What you and the other teachers that are out there, and or you and the teacher that you are working with. So an important thing to remember is to be consistent with the expectations. So whatever your expectations are, make sure that you both, or all of you, depending on if you have three adults in the class, make sure that you all agree on those things so that you can each look for those things while you are at recess. And the next thing you want to do is to divide the responsibilities for effective supervision so that you can ensure their safety and that there's positive play that's happening outside. And this may mean picking specific spots or specific zones on the playground where each adult will stand, just so that their eyes are covering all of the playground space. Another thing to think about is to get clear on the emergency protocols. So a lot of things can happen outside on the playground. So think about, you know, what should they do when there's a fire drill? What happens if you're in a state that has tornadoes, or if you're in a state that has earthquakes or something like that? What are the protocols for that when they are outside? How about if there's an intruder on the campus? What are they supposed to do at that point? Where do they go? Where do they hide? Where do they take cover? But also, what happens if a child gets sick on the playground? And of course, what happens if a child gets injured? What are you supposed to do? What are the procedures for that? So those are things that you should get clear on as well. And then you also want to ensure that the children are being included and engaged in the activities that are going on outside. So maybe you want to do a couple days where there are some times for like group activities, where you have like a group game or something going on. Or maybe you want to, you know, have like a buddy system that can help children who are slow to warm up to other children or something like that. But you just want to make sure that they're included, that they don't feel excluded. So how do you get them back to the classroom? One thing you want to do is have some type of warning, like 5-minute warning, that you want to do outside. And again, this is something that you would have discussed with them already, so that they know when they hear X, Y, and Z that you are telling them that they need to prepare themselves to line up. And then finally, when that time is up, what's the cue for them to actually line up? So for me, it was always a clapping pattern that I would do, and they knew at that point, okay, now recess is over, it is time to line up. And then you have your transition activity, a transition activity that can kind of prep them for the next thing, but also, you know, get them settled before they enter the school again. So something maybe like some type of calm down activity, maybe a breathing exercise or something like that. After they have took their breaths and they've calmed down just a bit, then remind them about what happens next. What's next in the schedule? And as well, you want to talk about your expectations for entering the school at this point. You know, reminding them that, you know, there are other people that are working, the office, you know, other classrooms, etc. And then here you may want to also do some type of walking challenge where you pick something that is quiet so that they can go into the school and get to the classroom door quietly. And then finally, they're at the door. So this would be a great time to let them know or remind them how are they to enter the classroom. And then also let them know what are they supposed to do next. Like, they have an idea like what's happening in the schedule as far as what's next, but what are they supposed to do next? You know, depending on the type of the part of the year that you are in, they may have to, you know, take their coats off, or they may have to, if you've taken things out of the classroom, they may have to find the spots for those things to put them back where they belong. And also have them wash their hands. So if that's the next thing, you know, let them know, when you get into the classroom, I need you to do, and then whatever it is you want them to do. And then think about it. Are you gonna let a few children in at a time, or are you going to let the whole class in at a time? And this also depends on if you have a second or third teacher in the classroom, whether you wanna do that or whether you should do that or not. Okay, so let's talk activities. I wanted to give you a few activities that you can do as part of, like, you know, some activities that they can do on their own, but also some activities that they can do as a group as well. And you may have children, depending on how you set it up, you may have children that just wanna, you know, do their own thing and play, you know, on the structures and different and equipment. And you may have children that want to do the group activity. You will have children that want to play with the teachers or want to do a group activity. So just give this as an option for them. One thing that is fun for them to do is some type of scavenger hunt. And since they're outside, a natural thing to do is would be a nature hunt. So you can have like different things for them to search for and then bring it to you when they have found it. But you can also include, especially at the beginning of the year, you can include a scavenger hunt where they actually have to look for the particular things on the playground. For instance, you know, have them look for the slides, and then, you know, you can make it part of a larger lesson where they're doing the scavenger hunt, looking for the slide, for instance. And then you talk about, okay, this is what we're gonna do on the slide, or this is how we play on the slide, or something like that. So you can make it fun so that they are doing this activity as a group, but you can also make it functional to fit your objective as well. Another activity that you can incorporate in your outdoor play are sensory bins. It could be something that is related to nature. It could be, you know, a bin of maybe acorns, or a bin of water, a bin of maybe some sand, or even like those rocks that you can get from like the Dollar Tree, something like that. Like, you can have those types of things out there, and it's something different. And I'm not saying do this from the beginning, but it's something that you can add. Think about your lesson plans and the types of things that you can do with them, especially things that are like science related that you can do with them outside, perhaps during their recess time as some type of supplemental activity. And of course, a favorite could be Duck Duck Goose. And I think Duck Duck Goose is kind of like, you know, of course, Duck Duck Goose, but a lot of times we do Duck Duck Goose inside in the classroom, which when you think about it, doesn't really make sense because we spend all day long telling them not to run in the classroom, and then we play Duck Duck Goose. So this would be perfect to do it outside of the, you know, and have it as a group activity, or maybe even a small group activity. You may want to incorporate sidewalk chalk if there's some type of like pavement or something in your playground. That may be something that you want to, you know, have them do and explore and be creative, and maybe give them some ideas or things to do with that chalk. And that's a fun little extra element to add to their recess play. And of course, you can make games with the chalk as well, like hopscotch or something, or maybe even four square or something like that. And then the last one that I want to talk about is, which is one of my favorites, is the parachute. So have some parachute play time in there. And once you take this out, they're going to want to play with it. And if you don't have one in your classroom or in your school, maybe make a suggestion to your administration to purchase one. And then try to get one that has enough of the handles so that everyone can grab one. And what you can do here, there's so many different things that you can do in with it, so many games that you can play with it that will keep them engaged and having fun during this time. So if you don't have a parachute, or if you've never used a parachute, definitely try it. It is definitely a winner. So I talked about five different activities and games that you can play that can be played outside at recess, but I also included some more on a PDF that you can download, and that is in the description. So go ahead and grab that so that you can have some other ideas that you can use at recess time. All right, so when recess is managed effectively, it can be a tool that can nurture the whole child. And remember to teach everything that you want them to be able to do before recess, during recess, and after recess. And don't forget to pick up that resource that I have available for you in the description. And until next time, I'll see you soon. Bye.